Right, so these are the tomatoes that I've got growing in the propagator. Now they are definitely not getting enough light, and look how leggy they are. So I'm going to put those in some pots and try and save them by putting them on a sunnier windowsill. But they're all overcrowded and they're quite warm. And I have watered them, so we'll get those potted up now. You're going to help the plant in, are you? Right, so I've got the essentials. I've got a cup of tea. I got these pot things that my dad bought some flowers from the garden centre the other day, and they look pretty decent, so I've kept them. So we've got some pots, got the tomatoes, got a gravel tray with some weed membrane that needs to be damp. Then I've got my sprayer with some warm water in, and I bought this from the allotment earlier. Looks handy for 75p, so let's get cracking. Just have a cup of tea. Right, so I'm just gonna fill up these pots with some soil. I've got some compost in a bag. So yes, I am doing this on my living room floor. So just get these filled up. Now this compost is dry, I do need to save these leggy seeds, well, seedlings, before I ruin them completely. But it just goes to show the window that I thought was the sunniest, it's not. So just do those three for now. I'm going to water these a bit with the warm water. It would help if I pump the sprayer a bit. Let's put the water there. These are quite damp because I watered them well yesterday. Let's try out my new tool. So, so we've got this little dibber. I don't know whether we can dig out with this. We'll see. So, I'm going to make a hole. See, the fork beside be better. Let's have a go with these. These are aubergines. So it's a decent enough root system on that. Let's pop that in here. I'm going to try and bury these deeper.
want them to be smaller, less leggy looking. I can always repot them later, so all these in this tray are going to be aubergines. So these are the Moneymaker aubergines. I don't think I need them all, but it's quite possible that I could kill more. Let's take a few, plant those deeper than they were. I think probably it's better to not wet the compost first. Let's try it without wetting the compost, shall we? It'd be easier. I only want this one tray of aubergines because although I like them, they didn't do much for me last year. So I don't want to waste space and time on them if they're not going to produce much. But then I might have planted them a bit late, so we'll see. I've got laminate floors where I can just sweep it up. And thankfully the cat's gone out, so he doesn't want to help anymore. Because he would have his head in these and he'd be trying to eat the seedlings. So that's just what he likes to do. Alright, so I'll try these with the drier compost. And I'm going to plant two, I think, in each one, and then discard the rest of the seedlings. Let's try it. I like this little dibber. Let's try the diggy end of this one. Well, that's better. So, by the leaves, remember. Even though I should be waiting for them to have more leaves, but these were far too crowded and leggy. So I don't want leggy seedlings. I want these to be these to be good strong plants, but we'll wait and see if they do. I'm not an expert gardener, but I am trying. And I always manage to grow something. So yeah, what do you do with your leggy seedlings? Do you start again? Do you give up? What do you do? Because I just keep trying. I always think they'll do well in the end. I really don't want to try again with aubergines. I can re-sow some tomatoes because there's still time. But these do need a long growing season. And I need them to be stronger and they're leggy cells at the moment. So, should we give them a chance of forming one of these? He's got a chance in there. Let's give him some water. And this is warm water because I don't want to shock them. It's definitely better with drier compost. I'm not saying it's bone dry, but it is dry. And then I'll wet the tree as well. But they have got decent enough roots. They're just a bit leggy because they didn't get much light, but that's easily rectified. So, we've got holes in the bottom. Yeah. Alright, so let's move on to the tomatoes. I will be right back. Thankfully, I've got a lot of pots, but I haven't got a lot of trees. Right, let's try again with some of these tomato seedlings. So these are the tumbling tomatoes, and I've got quite a few of these, so I'm just gonna put a four in each pot. Love this little dibber, brilliant. So that's dead, I'm afraid. So is that one? This one's okay. It's barely got any leaves. So the good thing with tomatoes is they will grow new roots from their stem. I've only got two for that pot, but I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll plant some more in there, some more seeds. Keep them in the light. Hopefully they'll do all right. So that's red tumbling tomato. I've got two yellow ones, so add these little two on. So I've got two there, and then we'll plant some more seeds. Luckily, these tumbling tomatoes are quite decent, and if they fall over, it doesn't really matter. So that's what they do, they tumble. There we go. So that's two yellow ones. So, I won't bore you with doing the rest of them. Just give these a water in. Let me just find some seeds. Alright, so this is what we've got so far. We've got the tumbling tomatoes in this pot. And
we've got the aubergines in this load of pots. Then in this one we've got the Bolivian rainbow peppers, the basket of fire, which I did in the propagator just in case, cucamelon, sun gold tomatoes, Shirley, and the ones I'm really excited about, which is the crimson blush. So those were all in the propagator, and then we'll go over here and we got some more tumbling toms, sugar baby watermelons, some more Shirley, more tumbling toms, and we've got the ones I did the other week, and then black cherry, black crim, cherola, and crimson crush. Now nothing happened on the indigo rose, so I might have to plant them again. So I'll sow some seeds in there and see what happens. But that's it. That's the potting on done for now.